everyone, it's Michael here with Home Health Success Academy and 10xpatientreferrals.com. And in this video, we're going to be talking about billing procedures. Like, how do you bill your non-medical private duty clients, okay? And we're strictly talking about billing by paying, you know, either cash, credit card, or checking, right? And the reason for that is we're not even going to talk about billing Medicaid or billing Medicare Advantage or other insurances. That's a whole other type of a section. But we're strictly dealing is asking the question, how do you bill your clients? It's probably one of the biggest questions asked of us when we have a company that asks us to consult for them. So the first thing I want to be able to share with you guys is cash is king, right? Meaning cash is probably the best way to get paid. But the truth is, when it comes to this business, when it comes to home care, non-medical private duty, I don't like getting paid cash. The reason for that is there's a lot of trouble that can happen. Number one, you may not report it correctly. Number two, you might forget to pay for the taxes of it because it might not get added to your list. And also at the very same time is it can increase chances of theft in your organization. Because if you're somebody who wants to start a company, the goal mainly is to be able to have the company run itself where you don't have to be an active manager. You can be somebody that views things. But the truth is a business when you can find somebody to run it for you. And so number one is cash is just one of those things where we try to stay away from in our organization because, you know, I've seen it where agencies, for example, will tell the, you know, the caregiver and say, hey, can you pick up the cash and bring it to the office? Or, you know, things just gets lost. Anything can happen, right? Theft can happen. Things gets lost. All these different small problems. So I honestly will tell any agency to stay away from cash payments. So let's go ahead and move on. The next question you have to ask yourself is, what's your billing cycle? How do you bill the patients? How do you bill the family members? And, you know, so a lot of people will say, well, we will back bill them, meaning that we'll provide the services and every 2 weeks we're going to go ahead and send an invoice. But here's the problem with that is they're going to send the invoice by mail, for example, or email, let's say. But, you know, the thing, though, is when somebody receives an invoice, you know, they may not pay you for another week. Or sometimes they don't pay you at all, right? And so that can be a problem for you because now you're 2 weeks behind. You really have to pay up front. You have to have a cash reserve to pay for your staff because your staff is not going to wait till you get paid so that you can pay them. That's just not how it works. When they put in their hours, they want to get paid on a timely basis. And you can't say, well, let's wait for them to pay us first. And it's just not going to happen that way. So, you know, you have to look at your billing cycle. You know, and the thing though is, like I said, if you send it by mail or even send it by email, it might take another week before they pay you, or there may be some delays as well. So typically for us, what we like to do with a lot of the clients is we like to do what they call a pre-bill, and we expect the client's family member or the client themselves to pay a week before the services. We know that we're going to provide, let's say, for example, 100 hours this week. Since, you know, if that's in the contract that we stipulated, we created that contract, they know we're going to be providing 100 hours on a weekly basis. So what we're going to do is we're going to pre-bill them 100 hours ahead of time, right? Now, if the caregiver ends up staying a little bit longer sometimes because the client requests that, then we can just automatically bill them as well or back bill them from there. But if we can get the money upfront as much as possible, it's going to work well. Now, you can also bill on a weekly basis, meaning that after we do the services, okay, we can go ahead and charge you automatically. So let's talk about how we do the charging, right? Checking. Can you accept checks? Of course you can accept checks. It's probably one of the best ways to accept the payments. But here is one thing that we truly suggest. If a client or their loved one is suggesting that they want to pay by checks, so that's why they're trying to say, hey, can you invoice us? You can say, hey, listen, we can definitely accept checks. And what we can do is we can do an auto withdrawal from your checking account, meaning that you just give us your routing number and you give us your account number. And so when the week is over, okay, we can bill you. We never allow it where we have to provide 2 weeks of service before we bill them. We only allow back billing up to 1 week. And when we accept payments such as that, they have to pay within 48 hours of us sending the invoice, okay? So that works that way. Now, there's one way where you can actually, when they have something about pricing problems, you know, we do several things, right? So I'm gonna just talk about how we do pricing. Let's say we start off the hourly rate at $29, okay? So if the client says that's too much, we can definitely reduce the cost for that. But $29, we're not gonna budge on the price if they wanna back pay. So if they wanna pay at the end of each week, it's going to remain at $29. But if they want a discount, then we're willing to actually say, okay, if we pre-bill you a week before, then we can drop the price to $27 an hour. Okay? So we don't mind adjusting the price a little bit, but they have to work with us, right? Prepay and you get a discount, postpay and you don't get a discount, okay? And so that's how we want to be able to handle things as much as possible. So with checking, it's okay to accept checks, but you want to stay clear about waiting for the checks to come. Because once again, it's the same exact thing. If they pay by check, you have to wait for it to clear before it hits your bank account. And when you're starting a business, when you're starting a company, every money that comes in counts for you. So we truly suggest that. Now, later on in this video, I'm going to share with you guys some of the ways that we can accept checks online, and I'm going to share that with you guys as well, okay? The next thing is you can do credit card by phone. That's a great way to be able to handle that. At the end of the week, right, you can call the person up and say, hey, just let you know this is the how many hours we serviced your mom. Can we get your credit card, your debit card, whatever it is to be able to take care of the payments, okay? So that right there is something that you can do as well. But that's one step extra you have to do. And sometimes things get falled out. You forget to do things, you forget to bill on time, and you can't get a hold of them by phone. So what we like to do is we like to tell them that, hey, can we actually have your credit card on file, right? Can we have a credit card on file so that we can actually use that to bill once each week is up? And so, you know, we're already providing care. We know we're providing 100 hours or 40 hours, whatever was agreed upon. So we just need that credit card on file to do the billing automatically. It allows us to be able to handle that easily and less transaction and less work and less phone calls, okay? Another thing that we do is that we use a certain software. And that particular software is that we actually just go ahead and do what they call automatic billing, okay? Where once we insert your information in there, we know that, you know, our system is automatically going to charge you. We don't even need to go into the system and put your information down, your credit card number, the price of what we're billing. It's going to automatically bill you. So if we're charging, let's say, for example, $30 an hour for services and we're going to be billing 100 hours, right, we're automatically going to charge you $3,000 every 7 days. It's automatic. The computer system will do it for us. So that's one thing you need to be able to kind of look into, okay, is making sure that you can do auto credit, auto billing. Now let's talk about softwares. Let's talk about the different variety of different softwares that you can probably use to do billing, right? The first one is having your bank, you know, send you a credit card machine, right? This is something that you can get through your bank account. And when you go to your bank and you have a business account, you can say, hey, just to let you know, we want to be able to accept payments, right? And so what they do is they physically give you one of those credit card machines that you go to the store, when you go to the gas station. It's one of those things where you swipe your card and you can automatically do some charging that way. Now, that's one option. The second option is there's other companies you can use out there. One is Clover, for example, and the other one is Square, right? So Square and Clover. So what happens is, you know, you just have to link that up with your bank account, your online bank account, and you can actually accept credit cards that way. What's nice about Square and what's nice about Clover is that you can actually do online invoicing. Meaning that if you want, instead of just sending them an invoice to make payments, you can send them an invoice where they can click and they can pay online. And people can pay using their phones, people can go ahead and pay using their laptops or tablets or even their PC, their personal computer, right? So that's one thing great. Now, another choice to accept payments is through PayPal, right? If you have a PayPal account, you can actually have people pay credit cards through PayPal and it just transfers to your account. That's another option for you to be able to handle that. Now, for my companies, we actually use Stripe. Stripe is an amazing software that we love to use. I mean, just to let you guys know, we're not getting paid by Stripe to say that use them. I just love the fact that it's a lot easier. So with Stripe, for example, we can set it up when we send an invoice to accept credit cards or to accept money transfer via bank payments through their checking account, okay? So we can do it automatically. Then at the very same time as with Stripe, we can do auto billing as well. We can seriously tell the client that every 7 days, they're going to be billed this much. And we can store their credit card on file as well. And so let's say, for example, if they go over 100 hours of services that week, we can automatically charge their credit card. And they get an automatic information, an automatic email from us saying that they have been charged, okay? One thing nice about credit cards is this. It's that the transaction's a lot easier. But you have to pay attention and be aware that each type of company has different percentages that's going to be removed. So typically, let's say, for example, you're accepting a American Express, they probably have the highest percentage that they remove from your charges. For like, for example, like MasterCard, you know, let's say for example, you charged $100, understand that more than likely, around 35 cents of that is gonna go to MasterCard. And there's gonna be other fees that's gonna be added to that. So more likely it's around 2.5 to about 3% fees. So you're gonna lose somewhere around $3 for a $100 charge. So pay attention to those kind of services, right? You know, yes, I understand MasterCard has to get their money also, right? That's why they do these type of services. But at the same time, as the comfort and ease that comes with automatic billing or accepting online payments or accepting these, you know, automatic withdrawals from their bank accounts will make your life easier. You know, I know a lot of agencies that have suffered because they back bill, then all of a sudden the family doesn't pay. And so imagine that you still have to pay your caregiver because if you don't, you're going to get in trouble anyways, right? So you have to pay them. So a lot of agencies lost money because they're unfortunately were stuck with a family member that wasn't able to pay on time. I've seen it happen, whether they do it on purpose or, for example, their patient or their loved one passed away, then there's so many things that they have to worry about, so many bills, and they end up not paying you back. And then here you are trying to struggle, trying to keep your business open, and you're not getting paid. So take a look at Stripe. It's an amazing portal that they can actually do, okay, that you can actually use. It's pretty user-friendly. It's a free account that you can actually have, that you can create. It's really fast. It's super, super fast. When you want to be able to sign up with Stripe, you just need your EIN number, your business company information, your bank account, your routing number for your bank, and then you can set up your account from there. Another thing is when you're accepting credit cards, there's some people, unfortunately, that are really bad. And those are the people that, unfortunately, will deny a transaction. That even though you were able to bill it, they're gonna dispute it, right? One thing nice about Stripe is you can do everything online, meaning that they're gonna notify you, right? They're gonna notify you when there is a dispute, and you can actually counter that dispute to make sure that you get paid. Because I've seen it happen a lot where some family members will then just dispute the charges out of all of a sudden, and you're not paying attention to this, right? And another thing about either Stripe or Square or Clover is that they have apps that goes into your phone. So you can actually see how much money is coming in, how much has been deposited in your bank account. So pay attention to your billing cycle. Now, you know, I wanna, you know, pretty much double up, you know, on your billing. You know, I honestly prefer that you bill before services, a week ahead or even 2 weeks ahead, or maybe a week after each service and bill, and rather than, you know, billing every month. I've seen some agencies do monthly billing, and that is a recipe for disaster, and I would truly suggest to avoid that type of situation, okay? So I hope this video kind of helps you guys out on ideas and what you can do in order to be able to do your billing and how to structure your billing correctly. If you have any questions, make sure you leave us a comment down below. Also, if you like this video, if you like some of the stuff that we share with you, make sure you like the video as well. Make sure you subscribe with us and click the bell button to be able to be notified when any new videos actually come up. Once again, this is Michael with 10xpatientreferrals.com. Please stop by 10xpatientreferrals.com. It gives you everything you need to be able to market and learn how to successfully get patient referrals to your agency. Have a great day. Hey everyone, we want to be able to invite you to our 10xpatientreferrals.com, where we have our online home health marketing academy that's going to be able to help either a home health, home care, or hospice agency increase referrals, increase their census, and create a profitable company. Now, at this very moment, you're going to have access to these information through these training, marketing to physicians, how to get to hospitals, how to be able to get into nursing homes, and much, much more at a month-to-month basis with no contracts needed. It's just month-to-month. Now, guess what? We are offering you guys for a limited time 50% off any one of our plans. Just choose which one is going to be able to work better for you. So just stop by the 10xpatientreferrals.com at any given moment. So these are the plans that are available, whether it's the gold, the silver, or the platinum plan. Most people go for the gold plan, but it's up to you what's going to work for you. We definitely want to be able to have you in, come in and work with us. So here's two choices. Go to 10xpatientreferrals.com or click the link down below. Take advantage of this right now at this very moment and sign up with us.